Hello and welcome back everyone. Welcome to my playlist, welcome to my course on JavaScript. And we are almost completed the intermediate course on JavaScript. So it's time to look back and see what all different things we have already covered and what all things which are left, which we need to cover. Like we need to cover the object-oriented JavaScript, or you can say a functional JavaScript, right? How we are creating classes, how the functions are getting inherited, what is a proto, what is a prototype, what is a bracket prototype. All these things are in depth. We are going to cover in coming 10 to 15 videos. That is the edge of the intermediate course before moving to the advanced. Okay, so before moving there, I will be covering few videos on what we have covered till now through these graphs, which will make you more clear on what all different things are there, because it's a visual representation like data types, right? Data types, we have a string, boolean, number. Non-data types are like undefined and null. If you do a type of undefined, it is undefined. Type of null is an object. Then data types of object type, like array is an object, object itself an object, and function is an object. If you do type of capital A array, it's an object. Type of capital object, I mean, when you are creating new object from it, the type of will be object. Otherwise, type of capital A array, type of capital O object, type of functions, all these are the first class function in JavaScript. Okay, but when I create a new array, new object, or constructor function using new hello, hello is a function, that I'm creating the objects, right? So these are object types. These are non-data types, like undefined, null. We use them to assign or initialize some variables and object in JavaScript. String, boolean, number, these are the predefined set. Now built-in objects, which JavaScript, core JavaScript engine is providing us. So array, all these are actually functions. Math, array, date, random, all these are functions. But when you create a new object, new array, new date, new string, new math, new number, all these is you are getting an object out of it. So either you create an array, I cannot do inspect, so I will also open the inspect tool for you to provide the complete thing. Let me try to manage it somehow here. And this is perfect. Okay. So we always create an array like this. So if you do type of x, which is an object, but so if you do type of x, which is an object, right? But when what we are doing, when we say type of, which is a function, right? I think this is a new feature in JavaScript. It is already giving you the value. In the new Chrome updates, it is already giving you the value, so you don't need to hit it. You are getting the value out of it. Type of object is a function, right? Okay, so these are actually built-in objects we have. Then the conditional loops we talk about, for of, for in loop, while loop, do while loop, all these kind of loops exist in all programming language, right? If else loop, switch case, for loop, for in loop, for of loop, while loop, do while loop, all these. Okay, now I will come to this document object later, but this is the document. So here I'm talking about the DOM APIs in JavaScript. When you work, because JavaScript exists server side and client side, so this time we need to explicitly mention what kind of JavaScript you're working on, talking about. So I'm talking about client side JavaScript. So browser is also coming into the picture, and here we need to talk about the DOM APIs also. Like there is some element in the HTML, so we can get element by ID, get element by tag name, get element by class name. Element attribute is setting some attribute on to a DOM node. Like you are setting a style property, putting the inner HTML, setting the setting attribute. Okay, so these are actually DOM at DOM events. I will not talk about it because they are not that much useful. You can just go through them and you will understand it. So whenever we click on some button, some DOM events are happening, right? When you click on submit button, you are sending the data to the server. So there are some DOM event happens on the browser, because here you are running JavaScript on the browser client side and you're submitting some form. So there is on click, on change, on context menu, on mouse enter, keyboard event, key up, key down, key press, all the other events like on focus, on change, on blur, on submit, drag events are also there, right? These all are events. So, and there are other events. These are most popular. Stop propagation, prevent default. So I will talk about this in the coming advanced videos. Whenever you click on some button, event get bubbles up to the top of the DOM node. So like consider you have a three division. This is a division inside that. You have another division inside that, you have another division, and there you have a button. So when you click onto that button, the event bubbles up, event bubbles down from outer division to inner division to the innermost division. So to prevent those kind of event propagation, we use these methods, stop propagation and prevent default. Okay, so let me just go back again to my JavaScript programming graph. Okay. So here we were talking about intermediate stuff. Let me zoom in for a second. So we talked about already these blue lines, core JavaScript. Okay. Then there is an intermediate JavaScript which we need to cover, which we are already covering. So I will talk about that, just this one. So we have worked with the objects, like how to define the methods in an object. Okay, how this gets initialized when you are calling a method of an object. So that we talked about this context, right? So like how we are creating the object, there are different ways. Either you put empty curly braces, let me zoom it, or we are creating the object something like this, right? Or we are using object.create to create a new object from the existing object. Object.create is a method and you are passing the another object here and you are getting the new object out of it. Object.create we talk about, object.assign we talked about, so all these things. So how to define new properties, how to define a method. So this is the object we have created, right? So here we can say hello. So this is a property and it is representing another function, right? Let me explain it further. So object X is an object, and what it is having, say hello is a method inside an object, right? So this is how we are defining and methods and all. Working with the functions, right? In the functions we talked about first class citizens. These are the first class citizens. If you type of capital F function, type of object, type of array, all are functions. So functions you can write in different ways. Either you can write an expression like for X equal to function. This is anonymous function or expression, or you can write a function like this, put a name, right? Or you can also write a callback function where function is accepting another function as an argument. We talked about if block. This is another important aspect we talk about. So if block, we created something like this, right? And here we were writing our code. So this is if block we created. Right, then we talk about the currying. Currying is just a methodology where we are doing the partial invocation of a method. So consider there are two methods, function A and function B, both are nested functions to each other. This we talk about many times, right? There is an inner function and it is taking another argument. So it is accepting A as an argument, here I'm accepting B as an argument, and here I'm returning, right? And this function actually returning this add one function, right? So when you call this function add six, here we are actually invoking partially because it again returning another function. So if you assign it to somewhere else, like if I'm assigning this to this is add function. So x, if you see, x is represented by function. If you do console.dir, then you will see the exact definition that it is having scope, and inside the closure it is having the value a equal to 8. So this is the partial invocation. Again, now you can directly call this method by passing 7, right? So currying, closures are the part of that. Then we talk about the JSON, right? JSON, I haven't talked till now. JSON is simple. This is a JSON object. X is a JSON object. So whatever is the proper object can be represented, can be called as a JSON object. So in JavaScript core, these are the two methods, JSON.stringify. So if you have some method like X is having 80 value, so it will stringify it. It will look like this. Or JSON.parse is another method which converts the stringified version into the JavaScript object. Right now it's a string. I need to remove them. Okay, wait a second. I can assign this to some variable that will help. Okay, now JSON.parse. I can pass x, small x, right? I'm getting the object back. So stringify and parse, these are the two methods, JSON object parse and stringify. And in the objects we will be talking about weak map and weak set, and promises. This is the advanced stuff, how we are managing the callbacks, promises, I mean how to write asynchronous code in JavaScript. Okay, generators, I talked a little bit till now. Functions, call, apply, bind, I talked about. To override the definition of this object, we are using all these call, apply, binds and regular expression. Then these are the new things which I will be talking in the advanced things. What are the new features in the ES6, which is Latin constant, string literals, for of loop, interface, classes, modules, import, export, default parameters in the argument, arrow functions, namespaces, generators, iterators. All these are actually new things which I will cover in the advance once we are done with the core ES5, core JavaScript. Okay, and external modules, I will not be talking about them. That's it. So let's talk something else in the next video, like what else or what more need to be covered.